I start off with watercolor paper. I tape it down to my board. And then I'm using some carbon paper and kind of an embossing tool. You can just use a regular pen or pencil for this, but I like it because it has a really small tip. And the text that I put on my computer, I first typed out the words that I wanted. And then the hardest part is probably picking the fonts that you want to use. And I wanted the top words to have a cursive font and then the bottom words to be print. So when I found two fonts that I liked, I played around with the arrangement, centered them, and then printed them off in the size that I wanted. And as you can see, I just trace over the letters with my embossing tool, kind of pushing hard. And then that carbon paper transfers it to my watercolor paper. And then you can use a waterproof pen. I just use a fine point Sharpie to retrace the letters again. And at this point, I sometimes like to fatten up some of the letters to make them more bold. But with working at as a smaller size for this one, I'm just leaving them the width that they are. Sometimes I do a Google search on different verses, and it can give you an idea of ways other people have arranged the words. There's always a lot of variations for the different verses. So if you want it to be like taller and skinnier or wider or more square, usually you can find some example of someone who's done it and then try to figure out one that you think will work for you. Once I have my words traced, I'm ready to paint. I'm using watercolor paint. It's Shinhan Pro watercolor paint. And I'm starting off with my focal point, which is gonna be a magnolia flower. And I'm using a kind of a soft shade of pink. And I'm just kind of drawing on some of the petals. They have pretty large petals that can be in kind of a lot of different arrangements. So I'm starting off with 6, and then I wanted to lighten them up a little bit to keep them pretty light. And then I'm adding some buds that have not opened all the way yet as kind of an accent. So they're kind of going away from the flower in both the directions. I'm trying to keep them real light. I will add some darker values later. I decided to throw another petal in there just to kind of help balance the flower out. Now I like to start with a very light value of greenery and usually some bigger leaves. And this is really a great kind of filler. It gives you kind of something to start with. I'm doing it kind of on the top and the bottom. I'm not gonna make this a totally enclosed wreath, so I'm gonna leave a little bit of the right side open. I'm also kind of indicating where the little buds are connected. All right, now I'm going in with a darker, richer green. And I usually like to start right behind the petals of my main flower and try to really kind of help accentuate my focal point. So I'm using nice rich color, and I'm being really careful right along the edges of my flower. It helps those petals pop out, because right next to the white, they're really light and you can lose them a lot easier. When I do leaves like this, I usually start in between two of the petals because it makes it easier to form my leaf shapes. I'm dropping a tiny bit of blue in while my green is still wet, just to kind of add a little more richness and variety in the tones of my leaves. Now I want to kind of bring some of this dark, richer color in where my buds are and add a couple little small leaves that haven't quite grown all the way in yet, just to kind of tie all of these together. When I paint these types of pictures, I always like to have a light and a medium and a dark shade, so the values. And then I also like to have a large, a medium, and a small for like the leaves or the flowers or the petals, things like that. So I like to have a variety of sizes and then a variety of lights and darks in my painting. So I'm always kind of thinking about that as I'm adding these in. So these tend to be, what I'm working on now are a lot darker. I also like to vary my textures. And a great way to do that is to add like sticks or some smaller type line work. You can do it with certain types of flowers or branches too, but the brown is really a nice contrast, and magnolia flowers, because they're on trees, they have like these great branch type looks anyway, so it works with this type of flower. And they make a great filler too, so I like to kind of add that texture. Now I'm switching to a more blue toned leaf, and again I'm just kind of trying to fill up some of the areas. I'm going for my smaller size leaf because I already have some big ones and some medium ones, and then I'm just kind of using this to fill out some of the space so it's not so empty. I'm going for a medium tone, so it's not too light, not too dark, but just kind of in the middle. It helps kind of draw the viewer's eye around the outside edges of the words. I'm using a round brush for this. I don't remember what size, I think it's maybe a size 4. But it really is nice to create the leaves because you can get that fine point, but then if you press down, you can get some width on the leaves as well. I don't use a specific type of brush. I just use whatever's cheap at the store. And that way, if I ruin it, it's not something that I feel totally bad about. I'm adding a little bit more of that texture with the brown just to kind of fill up the space to tie it all together. Now I'm going back over the flowers, and I want to really just try to pull some rich color into parts of the petals, but I do still want them to remain somewhat light in areas too, so I'm trying to kind of balance out that light and the dark. And I decided it's better to actually just wet it down with water and then drop a little bit of that rich color in so it kind of softly bleeds into the rest of the flower. It creates a lot more soft lines and blending. I'm going to do that to the large flower too, just get it wet with water, and then that middle color just kind of bleeds out into that, making for nice soft transitions from light to dark. Adding a little more darks in there. And I do want to try to define the petals a little bit more, so I'm kind of going around the edges of them so you can see where they each hit each other. Now I'm switching to a smaller brush. That way I can get into some finer details. I'm starting with this greenish blue mixture, and I'm not using very much water so that it's nice and dark and rich. And I am putting in the details of the leaves by giving them some veins. And that really kind of makes them pop and gives them a nice presence there behind the flower. I'll even indicate this some on the smaller leaves as well. But before I do that, I want to add a couple more of these leaves. I still feel that my edges are a little too empty and I want to fill them out some more. So I'm just going to go in with some more of the smaller magnolia leaves. Maybe that haven't grown to their full size yet. And just kind of fill out some of the area. Do that on the top as well. Look for areas that need to be filled out. And then add some leaves to kind of fill up those areas. I could add other flowers as well. Maybe some smaller ones would accent this. So if I wanted to bring a pop of another color in, I could do that too. But I just decided to leave it with the pinks and the greenery. And I do have kind of that bluish color going on with some of those smaller leaves. I wanted to define some of my bluer leaves just because they're all kind of mixing together. So I'm going back in there and adding a couple of extra to fill in some of my open spaces. My center of my flower kind of got lost, so I wanted to really push that and then again try to kind of blend it out into the edges of these petals. And then adding a little bit of water kind of helps soften those lines. I went in to add some veins on my other leaves just to kind of help them connect. I'm going to add the veins to my top ones as well, just with my little brush, my little detail brush. It's great for getting in all those little thin lines. And then I want to kind of add some color to some of the other areas. And a great way to do that is adding these little berries. And then you can draw little lines to kind of connect them later too. But they're a great way. Berries are a great way to add just little pops of color to kind of fill in some of the spaces and have it all connect. When I finish, I add my signature L. Ehlke, and then I'm going to put the year to 1 and call it a masterpiece. I go ahead and peel off the tape, which leaves a nice crisp border. And then this one, although it's a little bit larger than 5x7, I could use a mat and frame to kind of crop it in to make it a 5x7 piece of art. Thank you so much for joining me in this, and I hope you are enjoying these watercolor tutorials. Please share your finished picture with me. I love to see them. And then hit that like button and subscribe below to get more tutorials in the future.